My name is Brandon Silverman. I am a senior at Indiana University Ballet Theater. I am majoring in ballet performance with an outside field in business and with a minor in acting.
My name is Jaya. I'm a junior here and I'm pursuing 2 degrees actually, a Bachelor of Science in Ballet with an outside field in entrepreneurship and a Bachelor of Science in Marketing at the Kelly School of Business.
My name is Grace Jaramillo. I'm a freshman and my major is ballet with an outside field.
So my name is Marie McCormack and my major is ballet. My outside field is international studies and I'm getting a minor in French, so.
Being a ballet major in college, like, it's not the typical track for a ballet dancer. So it was kind of intimidating because I felt that it wasn't almost the right choice at first. And now I love it. Now I see the benefits of it and the perks of it. I have so much enthusiasm and I'm so psyched to be here every day. It's just surreal. You get to come here, continue your training for 4 more years, and that's something you really don't get in a company. Like, they're kind of expecting you to, you know, be at that level. And like, we're expected to be at a certain level here too. It's just like you have more time to grow and learn to find yourself. And as an artist, as a dancer, as a technician. And that's what I really love about coming to Indiana University Ballet Theater. Also, we get a chance to, you know, do roles more here at a younger age and get more experience on stage. With those roles, you pretty much wouldn't be getting in like a core or if you're an apprentice. Because at those rankings, you're just kind of standing in the back and understudying, and now we get thrown out there, which is really, really awesome.
Hi, my name's Sasha James, and I'm an associate professor in the Jacobs School of Music Ballet Department. Some of my favorite things about teaching ballet, in particular in this department, are that I came from a professional environment where I was working with dancers that are being paid to come here and work with artists that eager to learn and hungry to learn, and in fact are not being paid, but just want to, like, they're just like sponges, they want to get every possible conceivable thing they can out of the classes. I find it really quite rewarding. The standard is particularly high here. Even though the standard's high and they're hungry, you still feel like you have a lot to offer and a lot you can help with the artist's development that comes through the program. I love to see the improvement. I mean, like any teacher, I'm sure you love to see your students improve. One of those areas that we really see improvement all the time is in the partnering work that Carla Corbis and I do together.
My name is Carla Corbis, and I'm a professor at IU Jacobs School of Music. I was born in Brazil, where I started my studies in ballet, and then I moved to New York when I was 15 to join the School of American Ballet, and I joined the New York City Ballet. And I was a soloist there, and then I moved to Pacific Northwest Ballet, where I was a principal for 10 years. And I retired in 2015. At that point, I took over a ballet dance project, worked alongside Benjamin Melipier. And right after that, I got an invitation to come work at Jacobs School of Music at the Ballet Department at Indiana University. I'm so interested in individuality and bringing out of the dancers what can they be in certain ballets or certain works. So my main goal is to pass on the beauty of ballet, the details of it, and then what else can you do with it? Who are you going to be in this amazing piece of work that was created a long time ago, or in a new piece of work that's being created in the moment?
My name is Sarah Roth. I'm the chair of the ballet department here at the Jacobs School of Music at Indiana University. I'm also an alum of this amazing institution and program. My time here at the Jacobs School of Music set me up for understanding all that a ballet profession can provide. You don't have to be, you absolutely can be just a dancer who exists in their art and contributes to the world with that gift, but you can also be a brain and a mind that wants to see the world for all that it can be and encourage others and see what this art can do for people. Fall ballet is our first major production on the stage, usually a mixed repertory program, which means we have a bunch of different ballets on the bill. And the gift of that is that it gives the dancers this full plate of food, several different styles to nourish them with. As they delve into their performance career, they want to experience as many styles as possible. A lot of the world knows the rigors of a ballet dancer. You are an individual who lives inside your expressive instrument. You confront that every day when you wake up in the morning. What is this instrument that I have with me, and how am I going to operate it today for the greater good? I think that that's point one, is the artist, right? That's one of the rigors, is how do you operate your instrument? How do you challenge it, make it better, push yourself to succeed and hold yourself to a high standard? But then these dancers here add other rigors to the day in terms of a Jacobs School of Music student. They wake up early, they go to their academic classes, they come to the ballet studio, they shift gears. They have to stay committed, they have to stay focused, they have to stay in it for the entirety of our day until well into the evening. 5:45 p.m. we finish. And then sometimes they have to go actually back to their academic classes in the evening again. So the rigor of mental activity that you've witnessed just now, right? The psyche of the dancer and their instrument, the dancer becoming an academic, tackling all the academic feats that they have to hurl themselves over throughout the course of the day, and then the physical energy that they have to spill forth in the studio. We are asking them to be excellent at more than one thing. And I think that's a stressor, but also what a triumph. What a triumph when they leave here with an education and the professional prowess to hit a company and make a difference.
Being a dancer in college, I think there are very few other people that understand what it's like. We, in some ways, we're kind of living a double life. You know, the daytimes we're here dancing like a professional dancer would. We take class and we rehearse all day. But then at night we have to go to classes and we have to do our homework. And it's a tricky balance with time management and prioritizing certain things.
So I have a class at 7:45 over in Hodge Hall, and then that's over at 9. I'll come back here and probably prepare a little bit more for my day and then head to the studios. I'll be there until about 6 o'clock. I have class, we have partnering, I have rehearsal, and then I'll teach the level 3 pre-college kids. And then I will have an academic class at 7. And then come back here, eat dinner, do some homework, go to bed. These are my point shoes. I always take out about half the shank so that they bend better to my feet and they shape more to my feet right here. And I have to sew these ribbons and elastics on. I like the really thin elastic because they don't hold my feet back as much. And there's usually satin right here. I cut the satin off to make them less slippery. And then I also kind of just carve little slashes into the bottoms because that also makes them less slippery on the floor. It's easier to stand on. And then when I get to the studio, I'll put some jet glue in them. I keep the jet glue in my locker because it tends to spill in transportation. So I'll glue them right here in the tip, if you can see that, so that there's more support here. And then I'll glue them around the sides of the shank to keep them hard in the arch as well. And so hopefully that makes them last longer than a week. The standard color of point shoes is pink, but it's made to look like a more European skin tone. Recently, Fried started making a variety of skin tones. So they have 3. This is their bronze color, and it matches me. You can see better on my feet, but it matches me really well, which is nice. It makes my feet look better and makes the line of my feet look more seamless. Depending on what I'm rehearsing, I go through 1 or 2 pairs a week, honestly, and I'm trying to cut that down because it's a pain and it's expensive.
So I get up and I get ready for class. I go to the dining hall. I get breakfast and then I go back, get ready, and then I have piano or ballet history. And then I come straight from that class to the studio and I get ready in the dressing room upstairs. And then we pretty much have ballet from around like 11:10 to 11:30 until 5:45 when rehearsals end. On Tuesdays and Thursdays, I have a class from 6:45 to 9:15 that I go to. And then I do that, go to the library after until like 11-ish, study, and then I come home and then get ready for the next day, so. It's a pretty long day. I can be at the MAC for like up to 12 hours sometimes. Tuesdays and Thursdays, I have a class at 9:25. So Monday and Wednesday, I don't have a class in the morning, but those days I have a class and then it ends at 10:40 and I come straight to the MAC and I rush to get ready by 11:10 and I have conditioning and then we have technique and then we have rehearsal till 5:45. Sometimes I teach pre-college. Being a senior, like I'll stay and I'll film, work on stuff by myself. Yeah, I think the other day I was at the MAC for 12 hours.
My typical day is not very typical. I go to my academics in the morning, then I come to ballet, and then I haven't been good about it in the past, but I used to just come in kind of like 5 minutes before and kind of just like do little like dinky warm-ups. But now I come in and I do full-on stretching because it's much better, much more beneficial for my body. And then I, after ballet, go home and do more homework, and then I just relax and kind of unwind from such a busy, busy day.
I'm Kira Nichols. I'm part of the faculty at the IU Ballet Theater. I've always been a part of the ballet world. When I was young, my mother was my ballet teacher, and onward. Over the years dancing, I was able to experience some wonderful teachers, notably George Balanchine and Jerome Robbins. So when I teach here at IU, I try to bring my knowledge to the dancers, what I learned over the course of my career, and I share that with them. And I love to tell them stories about the days when I was dancing for Balanchine. Balanchine always said, "Don't think, dear, just do." And that's a really good one for here at the university because the academic students think a lot. And what they need to do is just listen to the music and dance.
My name is Christian Klassens. I am on faculty at IU Ballet Theater. I've been here for around 10 years now. I started out in Belgium at the conservatory. That was kind of an affiliation with Paris Opera. Then in the 90s, I started a ballet school. And I think now really my passion has always been about teaching. One of the most important things I find in teaching is probably my contribution to IU Ballet Theater and what can I do for young dancers today and to be current with the students, current in our education with companies, knowing what people are performing, knowing the latest nuances in training. How can we open doors to different places? I've learned a lot from being a teacher and from working with students of all different ages, and it's made me into a much more developed human being, I think. It's a great honor to have worked at IU all these years.
Getting injured is just a typical part of a ballet dancer's life. I think the key is to always kind of nip it in the bud. If you start to feel a pain and it's there for like a few days or a week, I'll kind of keep an eye on it. I'll go to Nicole in the PT room, have her work on it, look at it. She'll tape it or she'll, you know, massage the muscle out if it's a muscle thing. Give me some exercises. So she'll give me PT exercises to strengthen certain muscles or release certain things that would help with the pain and then also help prevent the same thing from happening again.
Sometimes in the middle of the day, I'll go to the PT room and I'll soak my feet in Epsom salt if they hurt. Make sure I go to PT like regularly. I'll heat up my back with the heating pads.
And also like stretching right after class, like when I'm warm.
Yeah, really it's like whatever my body needs that day. Like I wake up and it's different every single day. And I go through class, like class is kind of where I figure it out. And I'm like, what's my problem today? And then whatever it wants, I give it. And then if it wants nothing, if it's like fine that day, then I don't do anything. So some people have like this routine they do every day. And for me, it's like, I listen to my body.
Well, it's a big day. Today is, I know, today is the first day of Nutcracker rehearsals. I am so excited. And the best part, I'm excited to work with my partners. Like, I love working, I love that relationship. So, it's gonna be really special. This year for Nutcracker, I'm doing Cavalier, which is really special. I love that role. It means a lot to my heart. The music is just great, and it makes you emotional, and it makes me really emotional. I actually cried last year at the bows because it was such an emotional experience being able to fulfill such a dream. I'm debuting a new role this year, Snow, and this is my third year doing Arabian. This is going to be my fourth show of it. I'm excited for what I'm about to put out and excited to share this hard work and dedication with the audience and just kind of transport them away from, you know, whatever is going on in their lives. It's just a great way to kind of get away from life and just kind of be in a different world.
My name is Michael Vernon. I'm Chair Emeritus of the Ballet Department at Indiana University. I've been on the faculty here at IU since 2006. Before 2006, I was based in New York teaching freelance. My first Nutcracker season here, which wasn't my production, I was walking home with the dean and he said to me, Michael, would you like to choreograph a new version of the Nutcracker? And I said yes, because I'd already done that quite a few times in this country. I can't say I have one favorite thing about the Nutcracker, but I will say that I've always thought that the pinnacles of this Nutcracker were the two big corps de ballet parts, which is the snow scene and the waltz of the flowers, and the four pas de deux. I think those sort of hold the production together, plus the unfolding of the story. It takes a lot of experience to dance such a technically demanding role, and they're also artistically demanding and musically demanding. So it's not just the steps, it's teaching someone to become an artist. So really that's what we're doing, is teaching people to become artists.
I'm doing Grandmother in Party Scene, which has been a blast. And then I'm doing Chinese for first cast and then Flowers for second cast. It's been really fun. I've really enjoyed the rehearsal process. Chinese is just so much fun, and it's really been joyous to dance with like my peers. And I think that's also why Flowers has been such a great experience to learn, is because I'm dancing with my whole class, and this is the first time that my whole class is going to be on stage together. Being an understudy is kind of stressful, just because you have to be ready at any moment. So I know in Snow, I've been understudying two spots. The whole time during the rehearsal, I'm just going over both sides, making sure that I know what I'm doing, like what count I'm on, so that if I do have to jump in, there wouldn't be any discrepancies against the choreography or anything, or if like I messed it up. I overall think it's a really good experience, just because being in the room and learning new choreography is making you a diverse dancer. So I've really enjoyed it.
Performing the Nutcracker every single year, a lot of people get tired of it, but I actually love it because it's kind of something you can always go back to, and that's a really good way to see your growth as a dancer and as a person. Just watching, you know, certain steps that might have felt harder the year before and now they feel easier, and watching yourself grow through the ranks of the roles. And there's also something really special about doing several different Nutcracker productions throughout your life. You know, we all start at one place, and then as we train and get jobs, we go through plenty different establishments, and each one has a unique Nutcracker production. And so that's always really fun to find the similarities and differences between productions. This year I'll be in the core of the snow scene and the Sugar Plum Fairy. Rehearsals for Sugar Plum Fairy, they're really fun. They're not as like high anxiety intense as a lot of people would assume. It's a really supportive environment. Kira and Christian are always very encouraging and they always really emphasize, you know, musicality. And one thing Kira's been saying a lot to the Sugar Plum Fairies is make it magical. She kind of leaves things open to us and where we can find ourselves while still fitting into this role that's already been created.
I will be doing Snow Paw, so Snow Queen, and Spanish, and Snow Core. Snow Paw is really hard. It's challenging me. I personally love performing Nutcracker every year. Even if you do certain roles over and over, you kind of can bring something fresh to the role. The music is just so familiar and nostalgic for me. Whenever I hear it, I just think back when I was younger, like at my first Nutcracker. It was my first like big show I ever did. And it just brings back such great memories whenever I hear the music. And it's just a classic. It's a holiday classic. It's like you can't really go through the holiday season without seeing A Christmas Tree. It's the same thing with Nutcracker. You can't really go through the holiday season without Nutcracker.
Ballet is so special. It's a form of self-expression. It's challenging and it's giving off these parts, that, like sides of you that you typically don't show on a daily basis. It's just amazing to be able to help somebody out there in the audience. I know not everybody's watching you, but that one person that is, they're getting transported. That's what makes it all worth it, to help somebody's day, somebody's week. It's great, something that they've been looking forward to, like coming to see the ballet. We train so hard, we rehearse so hard so we can find these characters, become these characters, and do it with the technique that we have and give them a show that allows them to take a break from life. And I think that's what ballet is all about. It's about giving something bigger than yourself.
Ballet, it's honestly my life. I can't imagine not dancing. It just feels so natural to me to dance and dance to music and be on stage. The team aspect of it, the camaraderie, that's another thing that's so great about ballet, is you're like dancing next to your friends. I wish people would love it as much as I do. It's so rich with so much history and it's so impressive. I watch my peers every day and I'm like, wow, like how do you guys do that? How do I do it? I don't know. I always joke with people. I'm like, when I'm at that age of retirement, whenever that is, hopefully it's far down the line, the director's gonna have to sit down with me and have a talk and be like, you're too old to do this. I want someone to make the decision for me to quit so that I don't have to. That's a joke that I always make because I can't imagine making the decision in my life to be like, I can't do this anymore.
Ballet to me is an outlet because I find myself wanting to be very active. And I'm also an artistic person in general. Like, I love to paint and draw. Ballet is the perfect mix for me because I can be artistic and I can still be athletic, and I love the two. It's also just been something that I've grown up doing, so I've grown to love it so much, even through the discomfort that it puts you through and all of the hardships that you have to deal with when you are a ballet dancer, like pain. I just find myself really enjoying the art of it, and like during technique, I find it fun. And so to me, it's just been an outlet that I can really enjoy myself doing.
Ballet means to me, it's a place where you can come and kind of just express yourself silently without having to find the words for what you're feeling. It's an art form, so you find different ways to explore who you are, what you're feeling that day, and you kind of just put it into your work for the day, whether it's like being really organized with your technique or being as big as you can with your upper body and your artistry. It's almost like a therapy. You come in and you just explore what you're feeling, and it can always teach you more about yourself physically and emotionally, I think.
It's also a whole psychological process, being a dancer. Adaptability and understanding the sensitivities in life. It's also a way of seeing ourselves. It's kind of a view into your deeper self. Everything has a place. Everything we do, every thought, every gesture we do has deep consciousness. I think that if you're not really true to yourself, or really who understand who you are, what your core is, I think it's very difficult for an audience to accept you. The audience wants to know truth. That's always been my goal as students, is trying to get them to attain truth.